I don't know why the video stopped. Like I'm recording audio still. Kenny's gonna blame me, of course.
He's conflicted by better internet.
I know, right? Well, the thing is, it's weird because the audio is working fine, but did my Skype die? Is that what
No.
happened? Did my Skype die? No, my Skype's. Oh, there we go. I'm sorry, people who were watching. That was horribly unprofessional of me, and Kenny's going to be angry, but that's why I'm going to block that out, and it never happened. Because I am the
Yeah,
editor
yeah,
now.
yeah. I mean, it's not like he's watching live right now, anyway.
He might be.
Yeah.
Anyway. So, yeah, those are pretty good stuff. Like a lot of RPGs, I feel, could be very hit or miss with that regard. You could make it one of those scenarios where you have a really good game that lives on, and then there's times you could do a Final Fantasy X too. Yeah,
Yeah.
that. So, for my games that I picked out was the first and foremost, I would love to see a Payday 3. I would love for them to overhaul and make a brand new one and just really give us a fun ass kicker of a game.
And before the next DLC is just
Yeah, and
Title
before the
Three.
next DLC, right? I mean, honestly, it's awful because the DLCs are just, it's ridiculous. It really is. Just how
But
the
they're
way
good
they handle it.
DLC.
They're good DLC, but I mean, part of me feels like there's a diminishing return. There's a point where they could have stopped and then just built up number three. Now, there's that new game that's coming out that's like a World War II Payday 2. And I'm looking forward to that. And spiritual successors are one of those things that it's kind of hit or miss. And I mean, really, you don't know sometimes if it's going to be really good and be like BioShock was to a System Shock. Or again, you could end up with Final Fantasy X 2. That's going to kind of be my go-to whipping boy for this, in case you couldn't tell. So, another game I'd like a sequel to, and people are going to kind of be a little iffy about this, but I'd love for San Andreas, like GTA San Andreas, to get basically sequel as that was, like in that universe. Because after 4 and all their DLCs and then 5, it became very serious. It's not as comical, it's not as slapstick, and it's a little more mature, if anything. And well, yeah, that's kind of nice. They pulled it off well. I enjoyed playing GTA 5 and 4 and all the DLCs, but I really don't think that it's the same. I think that it's kind of. It's not that same bit of humor, and it's not as jovial as it was back then. And I'd love to see that environment, that sort of mentality pulled up and then just thrown on with a new coat of paint, you know? I feel like that would really be a fun bit of, well, gaming, just at the heart of it.
The guy that worked for San Andreas got fired.
Did he?
I have no idea. I just made
Oh.
up.
Well, okay. I mean, hell, I can't make fun of you for that because I make up the fact that we've got sponsors every other week. Oh man, that was good though. That would be fun.
I didn't notice that like that shift in story until you mentioned it now. It's like, oh yeah, you're right, yeah. And then
Because
it's
they
like, oh,
explicitly
maybe
said it.
so yeah, somebody else just like took that guy's spot, so maybe he got fired. I don't know.
I mean, who knows? It's very possible.
Yeah.
Another game I'd really love to see a sequel to, and I don't know if it would work because it's a free-to-play game, is Unturned. Because it's really fun. They keep doing enhancements and whatnot, but it's kind of showing its age, sort of. Again, it's one of those very Minecrafty kind of games, but it's Minecraft with guns and more zombies. And I think that if they gave you better building and maps and everything, I think it would really be one of those Minecraft, like it would be Minecraft tier, is my mindset.
Word.
So, off of video games, I'm
Actually, real
curious.
quick,
Oh
I
yeah.
have one more. I
Oh
have
yeah,
one
go
more that
for
I
it.
just thought of.
Go for it.
Because me and one of my old friends was actually just talking about it earlier today. There needs to be a Diablo 4. They're reaching
Three
that
came out
end
a
of.
while ago.
They're reaching that end of carrot on the stick. Like, they just recently introduced, like, the whole primal ancient thing, where it's just an ancient item, just with max stats. So there's really no more... That's basically the end goal right there. Like, there's nothing you can go past that. So...
It's been 5 years... Wait, it's on season 10, right?
Yeah.
So it's been 5 years, right?
Seasons are, like...
Six? 5 or 6?
4 months, I think? I'm not sure. But yeah. And they really just need more, like, story content.
Yes.
Yep.
Like, the actual story of Diablo 3 was actually not that bad. But there's no reason to play through it anymore.
May 2012. So yeah, 5 years.
5 years, yeah. Good call. I was in undergrad still.
Yeah. They're coming out with a Necromancer soon, but... I mean... They can't really do much else.
I know, they might as well just, like, fucking throw into the next game.
Yeah. That was my thought, exactly. Like, or, like, have it in a new expansion with Act 6 added onto it. But not much is really changing when Necromancer comes out. They did say they're adding some new stuff, but it's... I don't know how well that would hold up to, like, the current, like, game.
Mm. So Nick was talking all about those guns earlier, and I realized, and I was like, huh, why didn't they make a Borderlands 3 instead of the pre-sequel? Which was obviously not as good, but still still in the same area of everything, but it's like, the story's really, really good in Borderlands 2.
I have yet to beat a single Borderlands game.
Holy shit, you're Mr. Co-op extraordinaire has not been in a Borderlands game.
It's because I'll get like 80% done with 1 and 2, and then I'll forget, and then I go back again, and I'm like, oh, I don't remember doing this last time, and I'll have done it. But it's just one of those horrible experiences where I'm just like, oh, well, shit. That's a lot of wasted goddamn effort. But, hey, it is what it is.
I beat 2.
We should play it after this. We'll play it after this. Because I sure as hell haven't. I know damn well I haven't.
So, I think I have.
I beat 2 on the Xbox, but I think I only have 1 on the PC.
Got you.
Yeah. I might have beat 2 on the Xbox. Nelson might have carried me through it. Did Nelson have it?
Probably did.
Yeah, because I played with Dale and Nelson, I think.
That kind of poses the question out there, too, is... Do we kind of skew this more for the fact that it's a multiplayer and we want to relive those moments with friends? Or is it really just actual genuine anticipation? Like, I know with Payday, we used to do this as EOD. So, a huge part of that is I would love to play Payday 2, but only with you guys. Like, if I played with randos, I would not have as much fun.
Yeah.
Like, Danny throwing grenades, Mindy axing people to death. Mark and I actually doing work. Like, that was a very common mechanic for us. And if I was trying to recreate that with other people, I don't think it would be the same. Whereas games like RPGs, like Final Fantasy, obviously I'm reliving that sort of thing because I want to see the continuation of this epic, beautiful story and not just, hey, what am I doing here? Cool. But what do you guys think? Do you think it's do you prefer sequels more for being able to recreate that sort of feeling, or do you actually look forward to new experiences? Like, do you guys aim to recreate it, the feelings, or brand new stuff?
For the co-op games, I definitely agree. I'd like to experience those new things with the same friends I've been experiencing the past stuff with already. But for things like the RPGs, like Golden Sun or Advance Wars. For Golden Sun, at least, it's to continue the epic story that they already set out to tell, but never ended up finishing. And for, like, Advance Wars, is because, holy shit, that strategy game was amazing.
Yeah. Definitely.
Agreed.
Okay. So. Anime. You had access to $1 billion, any studio you wanted, any artists you wanted, any video game components. Bullshit.
This one's so hard.
What anime do you want a sequel for? And that's why I wanted to pace it out to see how much we'd be able to get out there. What do you guys want to see an anime sequel for?
Go ahead, Mark.
This one was so hard for me to think about. Like, for one in recent history?
Yeah.
I want Saga of Tanya the Evil to have a sequel.
Come on, son.
did you? Yeah, you finished it, right?
Yeah, I know. I'm just saying. I just felt like that was a cop-out answer. I'm sorry.
That is a cop-out answer. But
it is, I know. But like,
I agree, too.
Yeah.
God damn it. I could have said that.
But for like an actual real answer, I want the Gantz anime to come back. I want them to follow the manga to the dot.
And finish it.
And if they're going to edit the ending of the manga, yes, please go edit the ending.
Nice.
But yeah, Gantz is a good anime. I would want to see rebooted and brought back. Yep. Because, I don't know, there's just something about the action and the characters in that series that I really enjoyed after where the anime ended. Well, you know. And when the manga continued.
For me, a big reason why I liked Gantz and shows like that, the hyper-gory kind of ones.
Yeah.
It's just like Attack on Titan for the first, like, bit. You genuinely don't know who the fuck's gonna die. There is no plot armor. I mean, again, they kind of threw you for a loop with the whole spoiler alert for Attack on Titan circa 8 goddamn years ago. Eren gets eaten by a titan, and you think for like a good couple chapters or 2 episodes he's dead. Then it turns out he's actually a mutant who can transform.
Oh, okay.
But
that reminded me of a different show where Akame ga Kill. Yes. Where they didn't give a fuck who died.
Oh, that was
everybody
actually
just fucking died.
That
holy
was another
shit.
One reference to that I was thinking of, but I'm like, well,
they
no,
gave
we can't do
zero
a sequel.
Fucks.
They killed everyone.
All shows that don't have plot armor, those need sequels.
Yeah, that was one those of the shows that I read the manga beforehand, and then everybody was like, yo, you gotta watch the new anime that's coming out. I was like, oh, what's it called? I was like, oh, I read this, and I was like, oh, it's like cool. All right, tell me how it goes. I never watched it, and then everybody got to the point where something happened to
Chelsea.
No.
Lollipop.
No, the guy with the wires. That, you know what I'm talking about. There's a kid with wires who gets like.
Oh yeah, Lubba, I think is his name.
Yeah, he gets captured, yeah. And that scene is different from what happened in the manga, and then it sort of shifts into like its own story after that, but everything else is really good. That would be a great sequel. I haven't read any manga recently, so don't ask me what happens after that. But I think one of the more obvious sequels that we need is High School of the Dead, especially after we talked about this last week. Or
yes, we did.
Yeah, about the creator. Dying, yeah. It's never gonna happen, but we got $1 million, so why the fuck not? We'll fucking bring it out.
It's funny you mentioned this. Let's just take a bite of chicken nugget. Because,
yeah, chicken nuggets.
Alright.
Just share.
One of the, yeah, come on over.
Did you get any Szechuan sauce? Sorry, I'm off topic.
Jesus. So I can walk right into that.
Oh, yeah. So, anyway, Nathan Fillion aside, I actually was thinking Shimonetta. Because, again, I know it's $1 million, but I was thinking Infinite Resources. But it's not as catchy as if you had $1 million. But Shimonetta I loved because it was one of those very well-done ecchi comedies where it's ecchi enough that you're laughing your ass off. And that's the whole point of it, is it's a world where there's no more dirty jokes. And this, like, really bombshell hot girl is just, like, super dirty minded. It was hilarious. And basically, imagine a super cliche Catholic school, and that's like all of Japan. Very, very closed minded, very unaware. It's that if you hold hands with a girl, you're going to get her pregnant kind of mentality.
What the
So
fuck?
there's like this one girl who's like a fucking Terminator. Like, she is just super athletic, super smart, class president, just like the most devout, like, single-minded person who's like, I need to destroy all things dirty. And it's hilarious because these people are so close-minded, they don't know, like, dirty things literally if they're in front of them. So there's, like, dick jokes and, like, actual dicks in front of them, and they're like, oh, what's that? That's a weird sea snake thing. Huh, oh well. But with this girl, she was probably my favorite character because she accidentally, like, kissed and rubbed up on the main character, and she just.
You cut out.
Yeah.
Working. Okay. So what ends up happening is she like falls in love with him. She's constantly like actually masturbating, like thinking of the guy, but she doesn't know it. And then there's like one moment it's awkward as hell, and it's like the cliche one for this, like it's that meme of this show. It's her like with hearts for eyes, and she's like, "Oh yeah, I baked these cookies for you. I put my love juice in them." And the guy's just like
I remember watching this scene.
Yeah, everyone
Oh,
loves that.
God.
It's the love
Not
juice in
because
the
I watched the
cookies.
anime, but I saw the scene.
Yeah, because that's the meme of it. That's the meme of it.
Jesus
She's just
Christ.
like super fucking crazy. She doesn't think there's anything weird about it because she doesn't know that's really dirty. So the reason why I picked that is it's a very good comedy. It's set up for a sequel, but no. But the thing is, the voice actress who did that, who care the that character, I think is actually more. Impactful than the main female character. And it was unfortunate because she died. And that's kind of what this is all rounding back to. And that's why, if I had the full
But
resources,
in
I'd
the
have totally
anime,
picked.
she died?
No, in real life. The
Oh,
voice
okay.
actress died in real life. And
Okay.
that's why, like, as I remember, I was asking, why the hell isn't it a Shimonez sequel? It's been like a year. I thought they were going to do it. And I read somewhere that she had died. So, of course, it's awkward because everyone's like, yeah, she was a great voice actress because she gave us this character. And then everyone's like, yeah, well, this is her fucking legacy, is a voice cap of her saying, I put my love juices in this cookie for you. So it's kind of like, yeah. I don't know if that's a really good, I don't know if that's a very good legacy to leave, but definitely Shimonetta is one of my top anime ones. High School of the Dead as well. I mean, really, there's a lot of anime out there that I'd like to see, but if I had $1 million, I can't genuinely say I would invest it in putting a sequel to that. Like, Hunter x Hunter, I'm glad is actually coming back. That's probably one of the few ones I'd have put in for. Attack on Titan also. I mean, it's funny because a lot of the stuff that I'd pick for anime is like getting a sequel like in the near future. Part of me would like
Yeah, I was actually
Psycho.
thinking of, I was thinking of Code Geass, but they're getting
Yeah, they're getting a
freaking
sequel,
third
yeah.
season.
So I mean, it's kind of hard because it's a good sign because all these anime that come up, it's like if they physically can, because you know the staff who did it aren't dead, they're doing it. Even outside of anime, they've got like Invader Zim, Samurai Jack. I was commenting in our Discord chat how it's great that people are really coming back to all of this. Like a lot of stuff from like our era's childhood, like millennials,
Yeah.
like late millennials' childhood. And it's really cool. And
Fucking
honestly,
whatever.
huh?
Nothing.
Okay.
I hate just millennials, just triggers.
You know what's funny? Millennials extends to people who are like 33. They're considered millennials. I shit you not.
33.
Yeah.
Cool.
85.
I mean, I still don't understand where it came from. Whatever. Doesn't matter.
I know it's weird. No, I agree with you
It's
too.
weird getting categorized as a millennial when I'm like 25. It's like, what? How'd this
Yeah,
happen?
yeah. Well,
Like, how dare you put this label on me? I don't want this shit. Goddamn hipsters.
I actually took offense to it before when I was talking with a buddy of mine, who does he does Muay Thai with me. He was a Marine, and he had the same conversation with me. It's like, what the fuck even categorizes a millennial? And I was like, I don't know. I think people who are under like 22, so I think you count as a millennial because you're like 21. And he's like, oh, shit, okay. And I looked it up later, and someone's like, yeah, 85. And I'm like, what the fuck, really? But we're random as shit right now. sorry. Really, like I said, those are kind of it. There's a couple couple comedy ones, like Senyu, which was done by the same guy who did Samurai Girl and Ninja Master. I want to remember the Japanese name because I hate the English version of it. It's such a bad translation, but it's a short, and it was really good. And they cut it off, and it's funny because like, they made the joke. It's like, yeah, we got canceled, so they pretended that the guy who created it, like, they broke the fourth wall, and he's like, yeah, he got arrested, and he got thrown in jail for, like, 90 years, so he'll make a sequel to this in 90 years. And everyone's sick. Like, all right. Every year, like, on the countdown, it's like, all right, 87 more years to go, 83 more years to go. Let's see. I would love to see School Live continue on, because in the manga, it kind of hits a stopping point. But that was actually, I tried to get a friend to watch that the other day, and I was like, you can't read any of the bios, you can't read anything, just watch just this episode. And I remember you guys made fun of me, because I was like, fuck it, don't do anything, don't read about it, just watch it going in dark.
Yeah.
And you guys were making fun of me, and then you watch it, it's like, holy shit, that was great. And because there's a twist at the end of the first episode, and honestly, that fucking dog... I hated that they fuck with your feelings. And if you read the manga versus the watching the anime, they fuck with you about that, because the dog is in there for like a chapter, like he's a reference. And then at the end, when they're like, "Oh yeah, the dog's gonna be fine," they outright have a moment where like they break the fourth wall, and then one of the characters reading a book. It's like, "Oh, that's sad." You know that time you like watch a movie and then read a book, and a character dies in one, and you're like, "Oh, they're not gonna die in another one," and then they die. Yeah, isn't that depressing? I'm like, you fucks. You pieces of shit. But, yeah, School Live, I loved. No Game, No Life is probably the last one on this list that I've got of shows. They're getting sequels, aren't they? They said they are. I don't remember seeing a confirmation. They're doing the movie, which is a prequel. The movie's a prequel.
Oh, it's a movie?
Yeah, it's a prequel.
The art I saw was a movie? Okay.
Yeah, it's like episode zero, because it's before they get there. It's the war. That's why like you see all of them fighting, because it's the war. Because after the war, the kid Tet who becomes God's like, fuck you people, no more fighting. I mean that's really the end, is he's like, fuck you people, no more fighting. And yeah, because he's God, yeah. He's like, alright, I guess we're not fighting anymore. Let's see. I mean really there's nothing else that's not getting a sequel already that, I mean, recent stuff, Saga of Tanya the Evil, Akiba Strip, basically all the comedies I was watching this season, I really want to see a sequel for. Miss Kobayashi's, it's not even done. Oh yeah, it's done now, but I mean, I want to see another season of that. I mean, dude, there's so many things that are just amazing, and I mean, I can go on.
They should make a sequel to Fuka. If I want to see the alternate universe.
I'm good. I'm content.
What?
I haven't even finished it yet, but I'm content. I don't need to get myself angry or worked up or any bullshit like that.
No, you should watch it. It's actually a good ending.
It is?
Yeah.
Right. I'll watch it later.
we need another Shokugeki no Shoma.
Yes.
Because the manga is super good. That's one of the ones that I try to keep current with. That one is I was extra sad that the second season was only 13 episodes.
I actually haven't seen anything of the second season. I saw one episode. I got busy. Remember, fall last year, my life went to shit. Too much work.
Same.
Too much shit. But yeah. So, moving on. We have a special component that I had thrown at the guys last minute, and I feel like this is actually going to be the longest part. And I asked them beforehand, if you had $1 million, what would you pay someone not to see a sequel for? What would you pay people to say, fuck off, this didn't happen? Or more in my point, what would you pay someone $1 million to kill the family of the creator for, so that they'll never go and do this shit again? Obviously, for games, I've got...
It's gotten pretty dark.
Yeah, obviously, I've got Final Fantasy X-2, which ruined a beautiful story for me. I'm pretty sure we're all agreed Big Order should never have happened. It was a travesty. Lost Village.
That was not a sequel.
Huh?
It's not a sequel, though.
What would you pay not to see a sequel of?
Oh, okay.
Oh.
Yeah.
Man, that's... Oh, God.
Let the salt flow from
trash.
You.
Trash anime.
I might be alone here, but Bioshock 2 did not need to happen.
No, it did not. No, I absolutely agree with you on that. Bioshock 2 did not need to happen.
I mean, it's nice to see more of the world, but it's kind of unnecessary. It was like a little, like, hey, let's make something before we come out with Infinite.
I was going to say, I think Infinite is what made that look even shittier. Like, I remember thinking to myself, this is an okay game. And then I played Infinite, and I'm like, the fuck off my life. I'm about to, like, surgically drill myself in the brain to find that one location that has all the memories of Bioshock 2 and just... and gone.
I never actually finished it.
Neither did I. It was shit.
It's just because I don't know, I just got further into it. I was like, okay. No, I want a sequel of that. I want a sequel of that.
You know what I just want to see? Because I guess they did it. Because I never... I saw the whole ending of it, but I didn't know that. I guess they drew up other anime endings. So there's like one part where the one girl shoves the other one in front of a train. And I'm like watching this, I'm like, wait a second, those characters, they look like the girls from School Days, but I don't remember this happening at a train station. And then of course it's like push, I'm like, ah. You fuckers.
But yeah, School Days actually incorporated like three different endings in the anime.
Yeah, someone told me that. It was like the one where she kills him in with the knife, one where she kills the other girl and like slices her open, and then the other one where she decapitates the dude, right? Alright?
Yeah, and also the ending where he gets with everyone.
Oh.
Oh, okay. So
I guess
right
I have
now.
To that, that's
I guess I gotta the dump I gotta get off the podcast right now.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, no bye control bye. Over you, Mark.
So this is the yellow otaku and gamer. But yeah. So Mark, come on. I know there's plenty other things that that bring the salt out in you.
Sword Art Online too.
Sword Art Online in general.
Too. That is a kind of a gray area right there.
After
the first arc of the first season, you can cut it off from there.
Yeah.
Yeah, everything else after that.
Skip the second arc.
Fuck everything.
Skip the first arc of season 2, because no one gives a crap about Gun-Gale Online. Mother's Rosario, you can keep that one.
It was nah. It was meh to me. Like, the whole, what was it? When
But it's an entire story without Kirito.
Yeah, it was Asuna, and she was with this other group, and that chick was like totally fucking lesbian with her and some shit like that, and then they're like, oh, we're all gonna fucking die after this or some shit like that. Like, oh, we're not gonna play this game anymore. We're never gonna see each other. We're not friends in real life or some shit. It's like, get out. I don't wanna... Oh, God. It's fucking gross. I hated watching every minute of that.
I enjoyed that a lot more than the fairy arc or the gun arc.
The gun arc, I thought, was okay.
They actually had, like, actual characters. Do you really think the gun arc was okay?
Yeah. Well, the thing is, I stopped halfway through it.
No, you gotta listen when Nick is a gun fanatic, so it doesn't really matter.
No, but there's, like, barely any guns in there. It's just all of Sinon's ass.
I know.
I literally sleep with this next to me, so... Also, out of the anime asses of late, Sinon's was not bad.
Really?
No.
It was kind of flat.
I mean, I don't fucking care.
I mean, I don't like it. Yeah, I mean, like, I don't normally... Whatever. We're really
I don't normally look at it, but when they just shove it in my face like that...
Yeah, when they shove it in my face.
But, you know, when it had 30% of the screen time...
It's like,
That... That was highly annoying to me.
Yeah, it's like an obnoxious version of how they do Aqua. Where
Aqua's at least good because with it's Aqua, actually they make it
ambiguous.
Like comedic.
Yeah, they make it ambiguous as to, is she wearing panties? Is she not? Even I guess the figs that they make of her, they design it that way. They sculpt it that way. I'm like, that's fucking hilarious. But yeah,
with Sora, with Xenon, it's just like, hey, let's just shove this in the middle of the camera for
that,
like 30
that minutes. One episode.
I'm all for character development, but if you're gonna have the camera just staring at this,
that
region,
one episode where it was it literally
does not help
80% of her ass. Like, why the whole episode? Yeah. Just cut through it every time. It's horrible.
That's like a filler episode, practically.
Even though there was some form of character development there, it was just overlooked because people were looking elsewhere. Were forced to look elsewhere.
Yeah. Like the 30% outer reach of the screen. So, again, what would you guys... anything else? You guys have the... Aloha, you. You're the one that cited so much trash out there.
So I just threw out like two of them. Hold on, give me a second.
Can I pay to make Psychopaths 2 better?
See, I was literally looking at that and I was thinking the same thing. I was like, I don't want to say get rid of it.
I want a better sequel. I want a better sequel of that. I want Psychopaths 3 to bring back that crazy bullshit that they had from season 1. Yeah. And the thing is they have the material. They've got it. They really do. And it's just, I don't know. It's like they're like, I don't want to kill the golden cow. I want to stick with this.
Yeah. And I mean, it's not like season 2 was bad at all. It was good. It was still good. It just didn't live up to the first season.
I guess Putan is calling us a bunch of prudes. I don't know why.
I don't know why either.
Probably because we're not just raging. Like this isn't like a half hour of just, fuck this show. They should never make a sequel. This sequel should have never happened. I mean, that's normally me. That's like me on a normal everyday basis, but still. Like, I don't know. Let's see. For me, things that should not get a sequel. I definitely feel like some things were done perfectly, and they should stay that way. And these are things that are successful. Golden Time, aka the one slice of life show I actually like. If they were going to modify that ending, this is like years later and I'm still kind of like coming to terms with that ending. I mean, I'd probably fucking rage. Another one is Parasite. Which I think ended perfect. I think that was just like, okay, cool. Like, put a pin in it, guys. We're done. And I think that's good. I think where they left that one off is damn good. Let's see. I'm cheating and going on my queue and looking at stuff that I think ended so well, I don't want to see a sequel for. Kill la Kill was kind of... I was kind of thinking I'd like a sequel for that, but with the OVA and the way they ended it, I think it was actually very well done. I think that where they left it off at was very good. So, you guys are all looking very contemplative.
Yeah, I'm scrolling down my list looking at all
the stuff I watched. You guys all looking at the same list? And I mean... It kind of feels
really
like
hard.
That. Yeah. And it's good. I think personally that we're at again, a lot of the anime that we're all watching, I don't think there's any super outliers or divisive moments. I mean, everything that we've got on our overlay right now, which is wonderful, and just I love it. Everything's either got a sequel or getting a sequel. Or is a sequel?
I mean, there's like, there's like three sequels up there.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, the one
they're all sequels.
Some people
actually
are arguing that it shouldn't have happened.
All right, well, how do you guys feel about that? Because I wish Kenny was here for this, because I'm not a Naruto fan. I watched like 20 episodes of it, and I just stopped. Because it wasn't my cup of tea. I made fun of Naruto today during my D&D game, And when you make fun of something for being too nerdy in a D&D game, you know damn well it's nerdy as shit. Like, if you can mock something while playing a goddamn table RPG where you roll d20s, either you're a hypocrite, which, I mean, mind you, I am, or that shit is nerdy as fuck. Context being, a character wanted to know if she could buy the spiky things you could drop on my caltrops. She's like, yeah. I'm like, yeah, well, I gotta charge you 25 gold for them because these people who wear weird clothes over their faces and run like this constantly buy them out from me. And everyone just started dying laughing. I'm like, all right, good. But, so, Naruto, how do you guys feel about that?
About it getting a sequel?
Boruto.
Oh, how do I feel about Boruto? I have no idea, actually. I think the first episode just came out.
Did it?
Possibly.
Yeah, like just did.
Yeah, just came out. Because I remember looking last night, and it was like 15 hours until release or some shit like that.
Okay.
But I don't know. It's very like, I feel it's unnecessary, especially the way Shippuden ended. It was very, very closed down, very just like, this is it, we're fucking done. Especially the manga too. They're like, okay, we know this is coming, this has to be it, this is the fucking end. They final fight, whatever, did it, done. Little, like, I guess, closure chapter or whatever the fuck. They probably did it in the anime too. I haven't watched it, but that was it. And what was it? It's 500 episodes of Shippuden?
Jesus.
Yeah, and I think Naruto was 200, maybe. On top of, they had 6 movies, maybe 7, if you include the Boruto movie. And now they're making the Boruto anime. So it's really, I don't know. It's like, I feel like I'm going to watch it anyway, just to see what it's about. Because I have zero clue what it's about, but I don't know.
Huh.
I'm very on the fence.
I got you.
I'm not a Naruto fan myself. I just know people who are big fans of it. Right. I know I've talked to a few people who really enjoyed how Naruto ended and said they don't need to make any more.
Yep.
Yeah. Pretty much, and like,
oh, yeah. Yeah. And it's just like, I think, I don't know, it's been a while since I talked to them, but like, some people feel like Boruto's just like milking that cow. They're just trying to get as much money out of it as they can.
It's because of the way the story was created and how long it's been. It's just like, okay, they just brought it all together to end it perfectly with the way it should have ended. And then, you know, for them to do this, it's just like, it's like, do we really care?
Yeah, the way someone put it in perspective for me, because again, not Naruto fan. I think it might have even been Kenny that did this, but whoever it was, I can't remember now, basically said, you remember Scrubs? How Scrubs ended season 8 with, like, him recapping in his head, like, how everything had been the past 8 years, where he'd come from, where he was now, and even his future with his love interest at the time. They had a scene at the end of the credits where he was in real life shaking the hands of all the production members and cast members. And then they made a 9th fucking season that had no sense to it. That was how it was sold to me. I'm like, oh, okay, that's fucking retarded. And I mean, it's not a passing of the torch kind of thing. It's not a really well-crafted continuation or spinoff. It was just garbage.
Yeah, that's like the most skeptical thing about it. It's just like people scared it's going to be garbage.
Yeah. But I mean, who knows? It could end up being amazing. It could end up blowing us all away and just being better than the sum of its parts.
It could be. That's why I'm just like, I might as well give it a shot.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, personally, I couldn't think of really too many things that I would be, beyond what I've already said, that I would say should not have a sequel. Because either I stopped watching it, and that's it, or I've watched it and I'm like, okay, yeah, no, either it should get a sequel or it shouldn't.
Yeah, like, I mean, there's already like a ton of anime that only go 2 seasons at that.
Yeah.
And it's just like, most of them are, they complete the series with the second season. So it's like, without that, then you know, like Gate is one of those.
Gate, I had to stop after like the second episode of the second season because I'm like, okay, this is a little too much rape. It went from
I felt the same way.
1,000 like, times more rape.
I waited like 2 more weeks and then I was like, okay, let me see if it got better. I caught up a little bit. I was like, all right, cool. All right, good job, guys. All right, you did it.
what was it? There was the mother's basement component where he assessed like the Sword Art Online movie. It's like, well, at least nobody gets raped. Like, that was, like, my favorite tagline. It's like, you know you kind of fucked up with a show when someone's positive criticism is, well, at least no one got raped. It's like, is that really something to be proud of? Is that something? I mean, kind of, I kind of felt that way with Gantz. Like, there's that one scene in Gantz where, like, a mafia guy just dies, wakes up, and he, like, sees a naked girl in front of him. It's like, okay, I'm gonna have me some rape right now. And it's just, like, awkward. But, I mean...
Yep.
Yeah. I don't know. It's one of those things where you got to kind of also wonder, is it just like somehow more socially acceptable to have that happen in anime, like in Japan versus America? Because in America, that's like one of the worst. That's probably like if you kill someone, that's one thing. If you rape someone, that's even worse in a lot of
I mean, they are in like not modern times and a different world and all that shit.
Well, yeah, no. But I'm just saying like anime as a whole.
Yeah. I don't think so. Japan's like one of the bigger world countries, if you know what I mean. Like they're like a core nation. I learned that at school today. Core nation.
This motherfucker.
Come on, education away.
but I think it's like it's a really touchy humor. I mean. It might be different for us, obviously, because, you know, we're from the U.S. It's like, oh, fucking rape, man, shit. Yeah. But it's like, Japan, I feel like it gets portrayed a lot as, like, it happens all the damn time. Not, like, just rape, but, like, just sexual harassment in general.
Yeah, the, like, molestation on the trains thing.
Yeah, and all that shit.
I'm come back like, and be like, yeah, some guy kept grabbing me by the balls. On the subway.
I mean, it could have been a girl. I mean, you know.
No, I can't come back and be like, yeah, so old Japanese guy kept grabbing by the balls on the train. It's weird. Like, mind you, for some reason in my mindset, it's like the old anime drawings that Mindy used to do of us with, like, Kenny just at the kawaii thing and, like, wearing a sailor outfit for some reason. But I digress. I'm going to stop here because you yell at me. But, yeah, no.
From what I've seen with it, though, like, they only use it to, like, portray, like, the scum of the earth type people.
Yeah, totally.
So it's more for showing you how bad they are versus...
I'm sorry, versus, just, like it just dawned on to me how much that happens in GTO, because I've been watching it again recently. It's so funny.
Rape?
No, just like sexual harassment.
Oh, okay, I'm like, what the fuck, dude? Jesus Christ.
Sexual harassment. It's because... Like... Because, you know, obviously, you know, he's like 20, 24, and he's trying to, like, marry a high schooler or whatever the fuck, get down with some high schoolers. And then I just watched the episode where one of the teachers, they, like, it's a gym teacher, and he's, like, this really ugly-ass guy. He has, like, a fucking mole on his cheek and shit like that. And then he has the girls running laps, and then one of the girls is not wearing the shorts, and you say, who told you could wear sweats? Take them shits off right now. And then she's like, oh, whatever, right? And she like bends down and takes them off. She's like, oh, good. And then he like spanks her with the horn thing, the bullhorn.
Yeah.
As yeah, whatever.
Wow.
Nonsense. I mean, that was, you know, an old anime, but still.
Yeah, no, I mean, if you do that shit in America, you're as a guy.
Yeah, like, you're fucking dead.
I know we're getting off topic and we'll pull back. But yeah, no. Right. Let's see. I mean, what else is there that we can think of? I'm surprised that I think Kenny is just our catalyst for hatred. I think when Kenny's here, we just get a lot of angry. Well, I get angry because I don't have to host. I don't have to mediate about. I have a list of shit to work on and focus on.
Obviously Kenny's like the bigger critic out of all of us. I've told him before, and I was like, it's hard for me to watch things and be a critic about it, and that's why I can't write as much reviews in that sort of way, because I'm just watching for the entertainment. Mm-hmm. And then trying to look at it from a critic standpoint is just really, really off-putting to me. And he says he's the opposite way, where it's just like, oh, he just notices all those things that shouldn't be there or whatever, and it's just like, oh, I can't enjoy this if this is this, you know. But it's you know.
That reminds me of when we went and saw Transcendence. Yeah, he just did not enjoy it at all. But, like, I enjoyed it for what it was, but, like, I'm disappointed it wasn't as good as it could be, but I still enjoyed it for what it was. That's just how I am.
Yeah. Aloha, were you there with Nelson? Or no, when we watched
it? No, Nelson and Kenny.
It was just Nelson and Kenny, yeah.
Yeah.
And, it's also one of those things that Kenny does where it's like, yeah, he's the critic, but then, like, if, you know, he talks to us about it, and it's like, oh yeah, like we can understand what he's saying. It's like, oh yeah, that shouldn't have been that way. It's like, oh, that guy just like talked about the wrong shit at the wrong time. Yeah. Like, so, he knows what he's talking about,
and he's not nitpicky about anything either. Mm-hmm. Like, he's not saying, oh, this little thing right here, it's not right. It's like actual overarching problems.
Yeah, I got you. No, all right. So we've covered pretty much games, videos that we would want to see a sequel for, and then games and videos that we sure as shit do not want to see a sequel for. Anything else sequel-related you guys want to talk about? I mean, I want to hear for the last week, as those of you consistent viewers, the three of you, may or may not be aware of. But yeah. I'm really looking forward to this season. I think we've got sequels. I mean, that's the kind of good thing about this topic. It's really put in perspective for me now, especially, that a lot of the things that we wanted to see as fans that are out there are actually coming out. Like, I feel like we're vindicated because shit that people wanted to see is coming out. It's great. Mm-hmm. It's awesome. It's almost like it's a sign of the end times that people are listening to what the fans want. Instead of, you know, just arbitrary fucking bullshit. I mean, do you guys agree?
I just agree, but that's never gonna happen.
Yeah.
You guys agree?
Yeah, but I mean, I still feel like there's some that probably won't happen. Specimal season 3, Haruhi season 3.
Do you think Nisekoi needs a sequel?
See, I can't speak to
that. I didn't think so either.
I honestly feel like the anime was just to promote the manga.
Yeah. I mean, that's what 90%...
I mean, it got me to read it, so...
So, I'm still on my list here, so what about One Punch Man?
That needs a sequel. Absolutely needs a sequel.
Yes.
Yeah, because it's very action-oriented, and it's just easy to catch people with.
Isn't it getting a sequel?
Yes, it is.
They've been making it for a while. Like, I've seen screenshots and, like, scenes that they've released as teasers for a while.
That,
especially like that one wolf guy, the martial artist who's like the third strongest or whatever, or fifth strongest. There's this comical scene where he's like wearing a helmet. He's like, yeah, just give me like your strongest punch. And literally like a fraction of a second, like he had to jump out with like every fiber of his being to dodge. And like you see, it's just like a Deku in My Hero Academy. Like he just kind of punches upwards like he was going to uppercut the guy and like giant hole in the ceiling. Like, just gone. And he's just like, oh, shit, that was my life in front of me. I should be dead.
That was a great moment in that series. Have you guys... I'm pretty sure you guys seen Zenkyu no Terror?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's one of those that ended perfectly.
I would say I don't think that needs a sequel. I think that... Well, how would they do a sequel? Everyone's dead.
I think if they did like a spin-off or like a different character or something, it might be good. Like if they did like a spin-off.
That's actually literally how it ended. It's America. Fuck yeah. Daka 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 daka. I mean, a lot of shows like that again, we talked about that before. I think the ones that ended with everyone dying like that or 90% of the cast dying, stuff like The Departed, like in anime form, so Akame ga Kill, I never want to see a sequel of that, because that ended great. They could do a sequel, and they could potentially do it right, but there's so much propensity for them to fuck it up, I would pay them and say, all right, just go overdose on some goddamn cocaine with some hookers and never touch this series again. Like, here's $1 million, snort $1 million worth of cocaine, have your head explode, get a blowjob from a hooker, just be done with it.
Right, right. All the things you do.
Yeah.
You specifically. Kenny says, you're a lie in April.
Again, how the fuck would you do a sequel of that?
Futon.
Fucking Futon.
I understand the want for a sequel because it was exceptionally good, but there's no way you can make a sequel for that.
You know, I imagine? Press X to pay respects. Just the funeral. That's it. Oh, you know, that actually came out wrong. No, I meant that seriously, like an OST where it's like, they kind of have like the funeral and it. I'm sorry, I realized that came out really sarcastic.
Is there something that was like a shitty first season that you want a better second season of?
Ooh.
Because for me, I just looked at it, Joker Game was a shitty ass first season, and I feel like if they were to just take all the criticism they got for this one, and then just warped it into what the audience think would be better or something like that, or just revamp it, and I think it would be great. Because it was initially supposed to be just a bigger mind game anime than it was, and it was more like an episodic, like, four storyline type of thing that merges into one.
Yeah. Like, I'd love for them to wrap it. I feel like that's what they're going for. I feel like, who was it we were talking? Oh, no, I'm sorry. It was my Shadowrun group. We were talking about how Shadowrun consists of you basically running as a bunch of, well, runners. People who work behind the scenes to do a bunch of random missions, kidnapping people, stealing data, corporate espionage and sabotage, that sort of shit. And a really good campaign for Shadowrun is defined as you do like 7 missions and you have no idea why the fuck you did them. There's nothing that ties them together until the end when you all kind of realize, oh, I ended up stealing nuclear weapon codes so that Indian terrorists could blow up the north part of America. Well, fuck. When all you thought you were doing is like poisoning some corn, stealing some guy's daughter, for like kidnapping a guy's daughter, breaking into a weapons management plant and fumigating some spirit bugs. Somehow you fucking find out you had ended up stealing nuclear weapons for a dragon.
Okay.
But that's the sort of shit that like I expect Joker Game to be. If they get a sequel, I want to see it kind of tie together like that. If we're in the hopefuls, honestly, I want to see a sequel to Big Order where they say, I'm sorry, this is all a giant April Fool's joke. We just forgot what the fuck. We forgot that April Fool's is supposed to go one day. My bad, dude.
Yeah.
I had a quarter to make. Shit.
Oh, God.
Like, I just wanted to be like, it was April Fool's. It's nothing ever happened. Let me take back from like episode 3. This is what it's really supposed to be.
I'm so glad I didn't experience that.
Oh, you should be. Okay.
Lost Village needs
an ending. It needs something. It needs anything. Yeah. So I'm gonna be good, and I'm gonna fucking time box us on this. We are at an hour. We rambled a lot. Feel free to go to our blog, follow us on Twitter, and by us I mean the other three because I never say anything really ever on Twitter.
Yeah, follow me. I got more followers. I mean, I need more.
Follow
followers.
Me. I need more followers. I don't have more followers. I don't need more followers.
Follow me, I need more.
Yeah, right?
JK. I need to be ahead of the crowd.
Yeah.
You know?
But follow our blog. We're putting out data constantly. If you're another blogger or something, reach out to us. We're going to be trying to talk with more people. It's an initiative we're trying to pick up on. That way we can garner more fans, help other people out, and just kind of build up the community. Because honestly, I've been part of some really toxic fucking gaming and fandoms. But anime as a whole is surprisingly, like, the blogging is really nice from what I see. It's, like, nice people. And it's weird because I'm very skeptical of the internet.
It's very like constructive arguments.
Yeah.
If it does happen.
Yeah, I feel like without Kenny to say, "Fucking prove me wrong, come at me, bro." Like we're all very positive people. Like Kenny,
fight
you have
me.
To, yeah, fight me. Sorry.
So fight me, fam. Yo,
yeah.
You want this? We got yo. Come to my blog right now. Comment.
Kenny, right there.
I've been writing that in my like in one of my blogs. I was like, yo, if you don't like this show, fucking come at me. Right now, right in the comments.
All right. So, we are Yellow Otaku Gamers. We're gonna have our Black End back in 2 weeks. So follow our blog. Talk to us about it. This is gonna be up on Friday and.
Yeah, and next week we'll talk about the. What the fuck are we doing next week?
I knew you wouldn't fucking remember it.
Next week
we are talking about hype trains and what makes a hype train, which is ironic because
you're probably
not building up a goddamn hype train
for this
episode.
Okay. First of all, I wasn't here for this topic discussion, and I looked at it and I was like, what the fuck does that mean? And I meant to ask you guys about it, so now I know.
I feel bad because it was only Kenny and I that talked this over.
Exactly! You guys are just like, oh, here's all the topics. What the fuck does anime hype mean?
Yeah. What builds up an anime hype train? So,
is it just anime hype train or any hype train?
Hype trains in general.
Hype trains are like pretty massive.
No, they typed anime hype, alright?
Yeah. Alright.
So we're going to stop now. And we'll see you guys next week.
Next week.